So welcome to Module 1, which I've entitled The Platform, but really you can think of it as, where do I start? Who does what? Because when you start working with Oracle Intelligent Advisor, I'm assuming that you have some advice to give somebody, but the question is, who do I need to involve in the project? What are the different skills I might need? But on a higher level is, how does it actually work? So the goal of this chapter is to give you that big picture. And at the end of the chapter, we'll take a little guided tour into what I consider to be two or three of the most important areas that you need to know about right now. This picture has one goal, to introduce you to the fact that there are many different things going on in an Oracle Intelligent Advisor project. We could split it down into several different sections. For example, on the left, I've said model. What do I mean by model? I mean that somebody is going to have to describe this advice that you want to give and under which conditions you intend to give it. If I can use an example that many people will be familiar with is, if I go online and I ask, for example, under what conditions I can join my local sports club, well, there'll be some terms and conditions and some payments and some general rules for how you have to behave in a sports club. Those are my rules, if you like, that I need to model so that if someone comes to my gym and says I'd like to join, that I give them the best advice. I give them perhaps the advice that I'm sorry you're too young to join, or I'm sorry you can only join by paying this amount of money, and these are the things that you must do when you're inside my gym. These are the modeling tools and the modeling tasks I'm talking about. The administration side, which is the sort of the second chunk you can see here, is all about, well, those rules, they're going to evolve. They're going to change. Every business, every government organization have legislation changes, terms and condition changes. So you need to be able to understand how we go about keeping those rules up to date. Sometimes we might need to roll back and say, well, actually the rules for this year, I'm not sure they're ready yet. So let's revert to what we did last week or last year. Third pillar I've listed as integration. Because it's all very well saying I've got a bunch of terms and conditions or rules or whatever it is, but how am I going to make them work inside my organization? Oracle Intelligent Advisor doesn't exist in a bubble. For example, maybe you have Oracle B2B Service Cloud, and you want this idea of giving good advice to be embedded in the experience of people who work with B2B service. So that if I'm an agent in your call center and a customer has a particularly thorny question, maybe I can use it to give them the best advice, or even to get advice myself. So I've listed, and we'll talk about the technical details much later on in this course, all the different ways that we can integrate into the wider world. On the right-hand side is probably the most important thing of all, is who's going to consume all of this good advice? Is it a customer, a prospect, a citizen, someone who's concerned for the welfare of their neighbor? A member of the law enforcement agency? Who is going to consume it, and how are they going to consume it? Are they going to consume it on a mobile phone? Are they going to consume it on a big screen? Is it going to be a standalone kiosk? Or is it going to be one of those more invisible things where application X talks to Oracle Intelligent Advisor to get advice that is then embedded somehow into their application? All these things hopefully will become clear. At this stage, we're not worried about the details. We're going to focus on what I consider to be the key ideas for day one. Day one, of course, we're going to talk about modeling. You probably already know that when you work with Oracle Intelligent Advisor, most of the modeling you do, you can see it from my screenshot. If you look carefully, you'll see Word documents. Microsoft Word and Microsoft Excel will be the basis of how you describe your advice. And we'll take a brief look at that in just a minute. I spoke about administration. Later on in this course, you'll see how to use the administrative tools. Right now, all I want you to think about is there are different people who do different jobs within this project. Some people typically model, some people typically administer. Depending on the size of your project, you may find that some people actually do both or everything. Integrate, this is really just a sort of snapshot of two things. One, on the left-hand side of this slide, you'll see, if you can read very carefully, there's some information about an integration service. And then on the right-hand side, you'll see a pop-up window that says basically, how would you like to integrate Oracle Intelligence Advisor? The point I was trying to make here is that the modeling can also be concerned with the needs of integration. If I'm going to give advice, and I'm going to give advice to another application, then it helps me if I better understand how that integration works a little bit. And the consume, this is the fun part. How will people consume my advice? So for the sake of the argument, we've put on Facebook, and I've put a website or an application as well. These are not the only ways to consume a piece of advice. In fact, I like to say that OPA or OIA is build once, deploy or consume anywhere, but at least these are two of the main ways of deploying that we'll talk about a little bit later. You've probably kind of guessed that this initial part of the course is going to focus on the modeling idea. And if you're coming from another piece of software, then this slide might be of interest to you. If you're not, you can read it, and if it doesn't make any sense, it's no big deal, because by the end of today, it's going to make a lot more sense. The modeling concept of how you design advice uses lots of very familiar terminology if you've come from other software. So we'll talk about a user experience or a user interface layer where we'll build an interview with screens and buttons and pictures and radio buttons and what have you. There'll be a business layer. Well, we'll describe what it is we're advising on. Obviously, if I'm advising you on how to fill in your tax return, the data that I need from you is different to the data I might need if I'm advising you how to become a member of your local library. The abstract layer is where we go into more detail about how your world really works. You may say to me, well, Richard, I have a thing called a citizen, and a citizen has a tax return, but they could have multiple tax returns because there are different forms. As soon as you start talking about how objects and entities relate to each other, you're in this, what I call the abstraction or the abstract layer. Finally, for those of us who are involved in integration, we'll be talking about how we communicate and how we share information with things like ERPs and CRMs. So that very short chapter actually held a lot of information in it. So what I'm going to do now is we're going to take a little bit of a look at what I consider to be right now the key things you need to know. I'm going to focus on modeling. There'll be a little bit about administration. And I'm also going to show you where you can get hold of example projects. Nothing beats seeing what other people have done. And there are plenty of places on the internet where you can download them. If you are familiar with HTTP, theopahub.com, I've got plenty of examples for you to download, but there's also lots of examples built into the product. So, with that said, let's go and take a quick guided tour of the modeler and some of the administration features to begin with. I'm going to start with the first of the big topics from the slide, the concept of modeling. By now, you've probably installed what is still known as Oracle Policy Modeling into your Windows PC. And when you first start working with it, it can be a little bit confusing because you're not entirely sure where to start, but it's really very straightforward. All you need to do is read across the top. You've got a project, you've got rules, you've got data, you've got an interview, and you've got a big green button, it's not green yet, I know, that says debug. These are essentially five of the biggest things that you're going to be involved in if you're involved in Oracle Intelligence Advisor. You're going to be building one or more projects. Those projects will contain one or more rules. The rules will describe data. The interview will help you give it to your consumers. And the debug will help you work out if your rules are doing what you said they would do. So for the sake of the argument, I'm just going to go ahead now and create one right now. We'll call this Chapter 1. Of course, I'll show you in more detail what all of these options that you can see on screen right now mean. And you'll notice that the other options light up. And you'll notice it goes straight into the Rules tab because it's figuring, well, you might want to start there. I want you to notice that it's got a Word document and a folder. You've got buttons to let you add more Word documents, Excel documents, Word documents, so you're not constrained in any way. On the Data tab, which we'll talk about later, I want you to notice at the top left-hand corner, you'll see it says entity, relationship, and attribute. Those are three key terms that you're going to be coming across a lot in the next hour or so. This is how we describe the advice that you're giving. Finally, in these four tabs, you have the notion of an interview. And without going into any detail right now, on the left-hand side, you'll see it says interview complete, and a little icon that looks uncommonly like a web page or a screen. In fact, we call them screens. This is where you will come along and maybe build pages of advice for your consumers. And you'll notice that the debug button has come alive. When you start building advice, you need to test it. You need to, if I can use the term, unit test it. Does it actually work? What I've done, does it make any sense? That's where you go. If we now move away from the concept of modeling, there's lots of other jobs that will be part of an Oracle Intelligent Advisor project. I'm actually going to switch back to the project tab, because project is a good example of a piece of terminology that every different person in an Intelligent Advisor project tends to use, because it describes probably what you're working on. I want you to notice that you have buttons on the toolbar that say Add Project to Repository. If you are working on your own, well then, I suppose, the implication would be that you don't need to share any information with anyone. But the reality is, even when you're working alone, rather than storing information on your laptop, what we would like you to do is share it with something called a repository. And just to the right of that, you'll notice another button that says Deploy Snapshot. Writing rules, building a project is part of it, but also getting it in front of the consumers, as we saw earlier, is a really important part. So those two pieces of terminology, putting it in a repository for the purpose of sharing it and deploying it so that your consumers can actually see it, will become an everyday part of working with Oracle Intelligent Advisor. So I'm now going to go to the second thing that I wanted to show in this particular chapter. I've moved away from the concept of modeling, and I'm focusing squarely on what I'll call the administrator or the administration job. Administrators, who perhaps have to manage lots of different rule designers, lots of different people like me who build projects and who argue over what's the correct interpretation of a rule, once we've done our work, I just mentioned it, we might share that with a repository. And you can probably see over here, I have an icon that says projects. So this is where my work gets shared. So when I publish to a repository, it leaves my laptop and heads to the cloud, or heads to wherever this particular piece of software is installed. If you hear people talking about the hub, they're referring to this website. Every Oracle Intelligent Advisor has at least one hub, maybe a development hub, a test hub, and a production hub, so that you can work and maintain versions in development, do it in test, and then do it in production. Without going into any detail right now, you'll notice that there's a big button here that says deployments, another one that says permissions, and another one that says connections. These are all administrative tasks. If I click on deployments, you'll notice that there has been a deployment, which we'll summarize right now means it's in front of some consumers. Those consumers could be your colleagues, because maybe this is a development hub. These consumers could be the public, because maybe this is a production hub. But your work is in front of somebody. And you'll notice that it says it's been activated. And when I drill down on it, I can get some basic information about it, including a version history. This is probably the most important point of this whole section about administration. If there's only one thing you remember, is that the hub enables us easily to maintain a version history of everything that you've done. So that if you've had two different deployments of the same project and you're not happy with the second one, we can come back to the first one. So in the next few chapters, we'll be focusing on modeling and administration. But for now, that wraps up our demo of chapter 1.